position is that of a parent commissioned to live in a cage. To its appearance where decisions are made to not listen, and they got their fists in opposition to fair play. Must be in your submission to rage. You became a victim the same way the system that gave way, inflicting the same pain. You're convicted and can't blame. Recondition your brain till you convince you can't change. Understandably wishing family tradition won't land you in a position where you feel in the rain. Lonely without a home, cause now your child's grown. Wearing a milestone like it's the only tie I own. Crying when you're alone, hoping that God forgives you. Wondering if your kids do. No one should have to live through the violence that you've been through. The fight that's still within you. It's time to make things right and free the child that lives in you.
Hear me, see me, do you even know I'm still breathing? I listen to the sounds of a TV. The only thing that really wants to reach me. To my ears can't hear me, and to a silence that kills me.
There Billy stands at 20 below, gripping his coat that froze 2 hours ago. Dramatic, I know, but cold leaning. 7-year-olds waiting, takes another look at a picture that lost time painted. Put it away, I can't look at it. The truth stings a little when you look at it. We're creating a mold of bad habits when the teacher got 11-year-olds that blast at him, and the world tunes in just then. Listening to every word that he should have heard at age 10. Then daddy wonders where it all began. He could call you a father, but couldn't really ever call you a friend. You work hard to provide a home for good living, and you figured that's all that you really had to give him now. If you don't know much, know this. All work, no play, all cry, near miss, huh?
I'm still breathing. I listen to the sounds of a TV. The only thing that really wants to reach me. Daddy, listen. Mommy, please. There must be a better way to raise me. I'm yelling till my ears can't hear me.
It's once said that the grass will wither and the flowers will fall down, and every man must pass when his number gets called. But when a child takes his life, the top of logic don't work out. A flower never chose to pluck its own petals out, and throughout all the tears, it gets so clear that the son I held dear, I lost somewhere between my work passion and a child-sized casket. It's hard to grasp when these dreams keep flashing. His cold foot hanging from a stainless steel table and a white sheet stained with a mother's pain and grief. And every day I wake, the face is filling the pain. So I milk the scape. Both the ease is feeling the blame. Thinking, what kind of man am I? What kind of mother with you? What kind of life do we
see? I'm not sure if that looks epic or just like,
hear me, see me. Do you even know I'm still breathing? I listen to the sounds of a TV. The only thing that really wants to reach me. Daddy, listen. Mommy, please. There must be a better way to raise me. I'm yelling till my ears can't hear me. And to a side.